What's up, you guys? It's Deep over here, and today we will create this awesome paint text effect in Photoshop. Now, if you guys also have any tutorial requests, then you can drop them in the comments below. We will surely try to create videos on those as well. Also, if you want to keep learning how to create such cool things in Photoshop for free, then make sure you smash that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any more time of yours, let's get started. So let's first start by creating a new document. So for that, go to File and then select the option as New. And then you can set the width and height accordingly, or else you can set it as follows. Width as around 3840 pixels, height as around 2160 pixels, and then set the resolution as 300 pixels per inch, and then click on Create. Now the next thing we need to do is type in our text. So for that, select Horizontal Type Tool. And then you can select any font of your choice. Download link for the font I'm choosing is in the description below. Also, if you don't know how to install font in Photoshop, the link for that is in the description as well. And then you can set any appropriate size for your text. I'm setting it to 450 point. And then click on the foreground color. And then set any random color at the moment, which will be the color of our text. Anyways, it won't matter since we are going to remove it later on. And then you can click on OK. And then using the horizontal type tool, you can click on the document and then type in any text of your choice. So once you have typed your text, after that you can click on this tick icon in order to place it. Now the next thing we need to do is place this text at the center of our document. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac and then click on this background layer, which will give you the selection of the background layer as well as keep the selection of the text layer active. And then select Move tool. And then click on Align Horizontal Centers, and then you can click on Align Vertical Centers. So now, as you can see, now your text has been placed at the center of your document. Now after that, you need to make your text layer active by clicking on it. Now the next thing we need to do is bring in an image whose colors you would like to be applied onto this text. So for that, go to File and then select the option as Place Embedded. And then you can select any image which has different kind of colors inside of it. Now if you want to follow along the tutorial, then the download link for the image I'm choosing is in the description below, and then click on the option as Place. Now we need to scale up this image in order to confine our text with that of only some selected colors. So for that, let's reduce the opacity of this layer by 50% at the moment. So let me just do that. So now, as you can see, now our text is also somewhat visible. Now the next thing we need to do is fill the text with that of the sky in the image. So for that, we will have to scale this image up. So let me just do that. And the reason for which I'm covering the text with just the sky in the image is because that the sky contains many different colors which I would like to be used in my text. Now once your scaling has been done, after that you can click on this tick icon in order to place it. Now let me just make this image fit into the document. So once your image has been placed onto the text properly, after that you can increase the opacity of the image back to 100%. So let me just do that. Now the next thing we need to do is only make this image visible where our text portion was, and we need to hide it from the rest of the parts. So for that, we need to get the selection of the text over here. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac and then click on the icon of the text layer, which will give you the selection of it. So now, as you can see, now we have the selection of the text over here. Now the next thing we need to do is make sure that your image layer is active by clicking on it, and then click on Add Layer Mask icon, which will only keep the image which is inside of the selection and hide the rest of the image. So now, as you can see, now the only portion of the image which is visible is where our text was, and it is hidden from the rest of the parts. Now if you would like to adjust this image, then all you need to do is click on this chain icon between the image and the layer mask. And then you need to make the image and not the mask of the layer active by clicking on it. So as you click on it, the square box shifts on this image over here. After that, using the move tool, you can place the image accordingly. Now over here, you need to make sure that you place the image at a position where each and every letter contains two or more different kind of colors. Now I don't want to change the position of the image which was placed earlier, so I'm going a step back. Now the next thing we need to do is create a duplicate of this layer. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac plus J and then save the original one as a backup in case we do something wrong, then we won't have to start from scratch. So let me just rename that layer and then make the duplicate layer active by clicking on it. And then we need to merge this mask into the image, but before that we need to rasterize this layer. So for that, right click on the layer and then select the option as rasterize layer, and then right click on the mask of the layer and then select the option as apply layer mask. After that, we again need to convert this layer into a smart object so that later on we can edit it non-destructively. So for that, right click on the layer and then select the option as convert to smart object. So now, as you can see, now our layer has been converted into a smart object. Now let's rename this layer as original. Now the next thing we need to do is create a duplicate of this layer. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac plus J. Now for duplicate layer, go to filter and then select the option as liquify. And then let's zoom in into the image so that only the text portion of our image is visible. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac plus plus key of your keyboard in order to zoom in. And then select forward warp tool, and then using the forward warp tool, you need to hover in the direction where you want it to be painted. You need to make sure that your size of the brush fits the width of the letter over here. So for that, you can increase and decrease the size of the brush using the square bracket keys of your keyboard. So once the size of the brush fits the width of the letter, then you can start moving the brush in the direction where you would like it to be painted. So let me just do that. So as you can see, as you move your brush, it stretches the colors in the image. Now if you would like to undo a step, then all you need to do is press Ctrl or Command on Mac plus Z. And then let me just start again. You can keep moving the brush in any direction until you find the desired mixtures of colors for your paint. So let me just do that. So now this much is looking proper. Now let's start with the other parts of the piece. So for that, let me just reduce the size of the brush in order to make it fit the width of the letter. And then let me just start again. So now, as you can see, now our P letter is looking proper. Now let's do the same thing with all other letters. So let me just do that. So now, as you can see, now we have done the same thing for all other letters. Now once you are satisfied with your result, after that you can click on OK. So now, as you can see, now our text is looking more proper, but we still need to add some more drips into it in order to make it look more realistic. So for that, make the original layer active by clicking on it. And then we need to create a duplicate of this layer. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac plus J. And then we again need to go to filter and then select the option as liquify. Now let me just zoom into the image. And then using the forward warp tool, you need to create the drips of the text as follows. So now, as you can see, now we have added some drips to the text. Now once you are satisfied with the result, after that you can click on OK. So now, as you can see, now although we have added some drips over here, but it is not blending it properly with the text, and we need to solve that thing. So for that, make the original copy layer active by clicking on it. And then we need to add a mask on this layer. So for that, click on add layer mask icon and then select brush tool. Click on the drop down over here and then select the brush as soft round, and then set the foreground color as black, and then you can click on OK. After that, using the brush tool, you can hover over the area where you want to blend it more properly. So let me just do that. So now, as you can see, now our drips are blending in more properly with our text. Now the next thing we need to do is merge these two layers into a single group. So for that, press Ctrl or Command on Mac and then click on this original copy to layer. And then press Ctrl or Command on Mac plus G, which will combine the two selected layers into a single group. Now in order to make this paint look more realistic, we need to add some bevel and emboss. So for that, click on add layer style option and then select the option as bevel and emboss. Now in the pop-up, you need to set the style as in a bevel, technique as smooth, depth as 100%, direction as up, size as around 35 pixels, soften as around 0 pixel. Make sure you tick this use global light option and then set the angle as around 90 degree, altitude to around 30 degree. Click on the drop down of the gloss contour and then select the option as linear, and then make sure you untick this anti-aliased option and then set the blend mode of the highlight mode as green. Click on the color icon and then set the color as white, and then set the opacity of the highlight mode to around 15%, and then set the blend mode of the shadow mode as multiply. Click on the color icon and then set the color as black, and then set the opacity of the shadow mode to around 25%. Now let me just show you the before and after of this bevel and emboss. So this was the before and now this is after. After that you can click on OK. So now as you can see, now our text is looking more realistic. Now the next thing we need to do is fill this image with that of a nice background. So for that, make the original layer active by clicking on it and then click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select the option as gradient. Now in the pop-up you need to click on the gradient icon, which will give you a pop-up in order to select the gradient. Now over here we will be creating a custom gradient, so for that select the gradient as black and white. And then double click on the leftmost bottom color stop, which will give you an option in order to set the color. And then set the color as follows: E8, E4, FF. And then you can click on OK. And then we need to create one more color stop at the center. So for that, go at the bottom and one hand tool will appear over there. After that, you need to click on it in order to add a color stop. And then you need to set the location of that color stop to around 50%. And then click on the color icon and then set the color as follows: FF, FA, EE, and then you can click on OK. After that, you need to double click on the rightmost bottom color stop and then set the color as follows: FF, E9, FF, and then you can click on OK. After that, you can click on OK. And then you need to set the style as linear, angle as around 45 degree, scale as 100%, and then make sure you untick this reverse checkbox. After that, you can click on OK. So now as you can see, now our image is completely ready. So yeah, that's it guys, that's the final image. I hope you guys like this video on how to create this paint text effect in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then give us a thumbs up. It helps the YouTube algorithm in spreading the video. Also, you can share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.